This video has been rated River Song for cheeky hints and no spoilers. Hello internet, I'm known around here as Cat of Diamonds and welcome to my fanish reviews. Today I've got Going Vintage. Going Vintage is about a girl in high school named Mallory who decides to swear off all things technology and revert back to the 60s when she decides that what her boyfriend Jeremy is doing online should be considered cheating. Mallory gets inspired to demodernize her life by finding a list that her grandmother wrote back in 1962, where Mallory believes it was a much simpler time, and with help from her younger sister, Mallory swears off tech and tries these 5 goals written by her grandmother. Run for pep club secretary, host a fancy dinner party soiree, sew a dress for homecoming, find a stud, and do something dangerous. And it starts like this. Things I say to distract Jeremy so I can take a break from making out. And she starts a list. Listing is one of the many personality quirks that I adore about Mallory being the voice of this book. Each chapter starts with a list, and I am a listing addict. I make tons of lists every day, whether they're actual important to-do lists or really ridiculous lists, like who I would kiss in order to find my prince if they were only allowed to be fictional characters. That's actually a really good list. I really liked Going Vintage. It was a really quick, cute summer read, and I liked the idea behind it. This would be one of the books that I judged by its cover because it made me want to read the book. I thought it was super cute and fun and actually pretty topical, seeing as hipster is kind of in these days. Oops, sorry, we got knocked sideways a little bit. I definitely enjoyed the vintage idea. I think Mallory's quirky attitude fits perfect into the summer. Whether your age is younger and in high school or older and out of college like me. There were times where I was just like, ugh, what are you doing? But at the same time, I understood that this is kind of a rite of passage, your first major breakup, and I've been there, and I think that this is a really fun way to follow a girl and how she deals with it. So my shelfability rating is pretty high. It is a library book and I have to take it back soon. I would actually buy this book and shelf it. All the details will be down in the doobly-doo in case you would like to search for this book and add it on Goodreads or buy it on Amazon or the Book Depository. Let me know in the comments if you've read it and how you liked it, and if you haven't, well, let me know if you're a lister. I'm unsure how to end these, guys. I'm sorry. So right now, bye!